Right, it's the 1st of July, it's almost 1 a.m. and Hal and I are back at our first ever gym. It is the Mecca. It's been a fucking crazy week. I've been in Manchester filming with Sean Coffey. I'll overlay some clips. I'm literally wearing his jumper right now because he left it in Manchester. I've been in London today, filming all day, so that's why we're getting this push session in at like 1 a.m. We're both so sleep deprived, but I almost feel more energetic the less I sleep. But regardless, we're gonna get this push session in, the vibes are high, and we're holding ourselves to posting this. We're gonna try and upload every single week. So we're starting on the 1st of July, then we'll film the first week of July, 4 videos this month. So let's just get going and enjoy our week. Hopefully it's a good one. So we're into the session, I've taken a little break. I'm currently listening to my own DJ mix on YouTube. Honestly, life is so good right now. I'm just like over the moon with everything and I feel alive. I've said this to Hal so much. Because I haven't been sleeping, I'm literally just active all day. Active. But I am active all day doing something and it feels so good. This year has been the best year of my life without a doubt. And we're only just into July. This summer's gonna be crazy. I'm not jinxing it, I'm fucking affirming it. I'm gonna do some cable flies now, but I thought I'd come on and just say something wholesome because we're both really tired and I don't want it to come across like we're both just being moody. So yeah, life's really good right now.
All right, boys, I'm gonna turn off cleaner's fucking vacuum machine. Excuse me, can I do some?
Yeah, leave it to you.
No, yeah?
Sure?
Yeah, yeah.
Cool, man, what do you wanna do?
You missed a little bit here. There you go, lad. Give you a little break, you know? Wait, look, look.
Get to something awesome.
Ready? Ready?
Yeah, man, double it, yeah? So follow me to the moon. We can find a place where we can groove.
Cause we're just kids with grown-up powers. So we just finished the session. That was a pretty decent session. That was like so short, but it was nice. Late night vibes, there were like two other people in the gym. I thought I'd talk a little bit about my weight goals. I've been sat at 85 for a while, 85 kg, not pounds. And so I think by come like September, I reckon I could probably bulk up a good like 4 kg. So maybe we'll aim for like 89 kg or 90. But I don't want to get fat at all because this winter, I'm basically planning to just do an absolutely like outrageous bulk to, should I say a number?
Yeah, go on.
I want to get to 105
kg. Oh, fuck's sake.
I reckon I could do it easily. Because I feel like I'm just lacking mass. Like, let's be honest. The abs have been on point. They've just held up. So yeah, 90 kg by September. I've offered a lot, so let's cut this footage. Right, we're back home. I need to take off all my clothes. I've been weighing myself every single day. So let's strip that down, girl. We've gone to the gym, I've done work, I haven't had a tuggy, so I'm gonna go and do that while Hal sleeps. No, hopefully he doesn't wake up. And yeah, it's been a really good day and I will see you all tomorrow or whenever in the week because we're getting this vlog filmed and put out, aren't we, Hal?
Yes, we are.
Let's fucking go. All right, so I'm in the newly refurbished bathroom. I'm about to go out to a cafe. And basically I found that when I go out to cafes, because I'm sitting there, I have to do work. Whereas when I'm at home, I just sort of lay in bed and watch YouTube too much. Even if I still get stuff done, like I'll watch YouTube for a little bit too long. So I'm gonna go out and meet a mate at a cafe. The sun's shining, it's such a good day. But this morning I was a bit pissed. Like, you know those moods when you literally just wanna slam everything, like just punch your desk. That was me because I kept on getting just more things piled on top of me from like different jobs I'm doing. Crazy how self-conscious filming makes you. Like, I'm literally lean right now, but I feel like my face looks so fat on camera. Like, my eyes look weird. That sounds like such a pick me boy thing, but honestly, I hate it because I just want to be able to film and not care. So I need to do exactly that.
Okay, 3.
Alright, so I'm currently on the way to the gym. It is Saturday. I tried to call Hal so I could explain everything to the camera and to him at the same time with what I want to do this session. But basically, I kind of just want to get the pool session over and done with and then film a bunch of TikTok clips, because I know that that's the way that you blow up on socials. So I'm going to start pushing TikTok. All right, so I'm currently sat at the bus stop. I'm about to get the bus to Howes, and then we're going to walk to the gym. Margaret Thatcher said, if you don't stop taking the bus by the time you turn 26, you failed in life. I low-key agree with that. Like, I don't want to be taking the bus when I'm 26. I want to be whipping around in a Range Rover by then. This is an interesting view because this is where I sat to get secondary school every day. So this is the view. This is what I'd look at every single morning, and I'd have music in and I'd just be thinking about life, deeping everything, what I want to do with my life. And I feel like this is just a really significant view for me. So one day, I really do just want to get a painting, like, of my view from this bus stop, because this has been my view through everything, like throughout the 5 years I was at secondary school, now in college, to get to the gym, to improve myself there. So one day we'll make that happen. Oh my God, you can't see shit because I've got a lens cap on.
I just had some fat combo.
Really? Hand to her. All right, you ready? This is the world's first dry scoop of pre-workout while playing the piano. How perfect is this? We've literally got a mate who works at the gym.
How OP is this?
Bro, I'm excited.
We've literally
about
got
that.
A mate.
Earlier, I was meant to FaceTime Hal and talk to him while I was on the way to his, so I could explain what we were doing today to him and to you at the same time. But you were busy talking to your parents about basically investing in a laptop, because he's basically just been borrowing mine right now, because I'm that kind of friend.
He is that kind of friend.
But it's crazy, I was thinking about
wholesome,
it.
Wholesome content.
We're literally at a point now, at 17, where we're making these big life decisions, like,
yeah.
That decision.
No one else is, people are like our age. Shout out anyone on here that's watching this, that the only life decisions they make is what Elf Bar flavour. You can go actually fuck yourself.
what Elf Bar flavour should I get today?
The decision to get that laptop, even though it doesn't seem like a big deal to probably other people, you getting your own laptop so you can edit the videos.
My dad said he's got a hard drive as well that I can have, so I don't need to buy an SSD.
We're basically just at the point in our lives, and my mates told me this, who are older than me, 17 is like the best year, and I feel that because I almost feel younger than when I was 16. I think the reason I feel younger than when I was 16 is because I've got so many more opportunities, because you get trusted with more. You get trusted with more when you're 17, therefore you feel younger because you realise how little you know and how much there is out there to explore. True.
Unless I get in some trouble with some men that I do not want to be in trouble with, everyone else is an NPC to me.
This guy's such a wanker.
Right, so we're here at Underground Gym. This is where we train. Check it out.
NPC. Look at this fucking neat with this drone.
I love my drone. Okay guys, we're about to get into the gym session, but before we do, here's 10 reasons why drones are the best device ever.
Let's go.
Wait, give me a sec.
No, stay there, mate.
You're good.
It's chill. We're not recording.
Do you want to be a part of the video?
We're not recording anything.
Safe guy.
My new ID.
Oh my God, mate.
Thank you, driver.
Pancake syrup.
It's the dead syrup out of it.
Last time I had this at yours. Oh, so good. So,
just thought it was a bit of B-roll.
We just finished up in the gym. That was a pretty good leg session, I think. My legs are fucking finished. It's Sunday, we're just gonna go home, do some work, some editing work.
Editing work, fucking money moves, big stacks.
Make some money.
Fucking dosh, dough, cash, flat.
So this would be a good day, training legs and making money.
I'm walking to college, it's Monday. Got a pretty easy day, but later I just need to edit Sean's vlog. And I need to get a haircut, so I literally look like a creature. I'm wearing the Mickey Mouse jacket, big up. Yeah, pretty straightforward day at college and stuff gets busy starting from tomorrow.
So we are currently packing the equipment for Wednesday. How much do you reckon this room is worth right now? All the stuff we've got in it? Each light is like a grand, right? Look at all these lenses. I might just, wait.
Oh, I've got 4 minutes to run the whole stretch to the train. I'm gonna make it,
All right, so it's Monday night slash Tuesday morning. It's 1 a.m. right now. And I've basically been editing this vlog from Manchester that I filmed for Sean since about 8 p.m. Usually how my college days work is that I have lessons from 8:50 until 1:30. And I'll usually have like a free lesson every day. So I really only have like 3 lessons maximum. And then from 1:30 until 3 or 4 p.m, depending on the day, I'll have cricket. So that's quite time consuming. It means I get home at about 5 and then usually I'll sleep because I'll be knackered from the day for about an hour. Oh fuck, I wouldn't say this on camera. Do you know what? I literally don't care. My ex goes to the college that I'm playing cricket at tomorrow. The one thing when I was with her that I always used to think about was sort of wondering what it's like to be in that world, because it's literally a different world going to private school. Like, oh God, people who are watching this who go to private school are gonna think I'm such a weirdo and they're gonna like clip this. But it's true, like don't even lie to me. If you go to a private school, it is a bit like being in a cult. Even though I wouldn't wanna go there, I've always wanted to experience that for like a day or a week. Just like everyone wants to swap schools for a day or a week, I wanna experience that private school life. So to cut to the chase, there's 3 matches at that college this week. I got selected for the one that has like a banquet after it, literally the one match. So I get to play cricket all day. And then I feel like I'm completing like a little wish of mine because I get to do that banquet, see inside the college properly, try their food. No one knows this about me, but I actually had a trial day at a private school when I was like 11 and I just fucking hated it. I walked in and they were sat down singing like prayers in the assembly room. And I was like, I'm not about that life. Wednesday, I'm on a short film shoot and I've been helping with the pre-production as well as the proper producer who's been doing most of it. So then on Wednesday, that shoot kicks off for 2 days, but I've also got a Communist Russia exam in the morning, which I'm actually excited for. And then Wednesday evening, I need to start editing a podcast. Thursday, I need to edit that so it's finished, because literally Thursday night, it needs to be uploaded and it's an hour show. Thursday, again, I'm on that shoot all day. Friday, I'm going up to London for a different podcast that I'm working on just for work experience. It's not paid, but I literally don't care. Like, I absolutely love going up there. And then the weekend, I should just have some time to myself to like catch up on other edits that I've got. And hopefully, well, no, I will set up my business in the summer. And also I'm going away to Prague with Hal. That's his first time traveling away from his family. And that's my first like proper abroad trip. So that's gonna be so cool. And we're gonna bring a camera. We're gonna make sure we film all of it. Because at the end of the day, in my Instagram bio, it literally says documenting my life. Like, I want my whole life on camera because I just think it's fucked how you die. And when you die, you lose all your memories. This got deep real quick. But yeah, that's a rundown of my week. And there's lots more in the summer that I'll go over another time.
I'm currently walking to college. It's the day. Yeah, I'm excited. The weather's really nice. Good vibes only. Look like a wanker with my cap backwards. Let's get it. Toby Toth, tell us about your innings. I wanna take a little time to refresh your mind, because the boys are back in town with a different kind of funk. Who got the funk? We got the funk, right?
We've infiltrated Hearst. We now own this place.
Ooh. Oh, babe. Oh, no. Mugging the whole of Hearst. Done my exam, and now we're on our way to the media production. We're getting in a fresh whip.
It is quite a fresh whip.
Fresh whip. Time to go and film. We're nearly done with the shoot.
1 hour left, day one.
Everyone's going slightly crazy because yeah, we've been here all day. But the vibes are good. We're all happy. We were outside earlier, and right there were 2 Lamborghinis electric. How many Teslas? 3?
4.
4 Teslas.
4 Teslas.
A Range Rover, just casually.
Whoa.
One day, boys. One day.
Alright, so I'm currently in the kitchen with my stained t-shirt. Thank you. Our catering today was chicken wraps, beef wraps, and some vegan options. I did the catering all by myself today as the assistant producer. And I also booked this whole venue. I did the recce, I found it online, and I think it's a very nice spot.
Oh, God. The latest here, Marky single.
Oh,
pan it around to here, Kai? So I'm currently sitting in the spot where yesterday we came out, we were on our break, and there were two women here sitting smoking crack. So I feel blessed. Ready for this transition?
Now, I need to pick me up from Ardingly College and take me to Sainsbury at Taywood.
My camera battery is about to die, so I need to make this quick. But I'm in London. I'm up to film a podcast today. I don't know if I can say who I'm filming, but they've got around 300k on YouTube, which is sick. And this place is really nice. And you can see the view, the backdrop as well. This place is all like bougie. I'm sat here doing some editing work, but I need to go now and film for the day. Right, it is now Saturday. I should have wrapped up this video yesterday, but I didn't come back from London until about 12 a.m. So that's what I'm doing now. That is this episode of Life. I hope you enjoyed it. Give me honest feedback, like how I talk to the camera, how I film myself, what I get up to. I know I haven't been able to film everything this week, but I've got two more weeks of college and then I'll be able to film pretty much everything and hopefully get out even more content. So follow me on Instagram, follow me on YouTube, and I'll see you in the next episode of My Life.